Dearly beloved, we are gathered here today to witness a truly special occasion where this man, Jason Walters, and this woman, Riddell Kessner, are coming together in the presence of God and all of you to enter the sacred union of marriage. For you see, what these two are about to do is by no means a light matter or a trivial act. Marriage is a relationship like no other, for it is something that God himself ordained and created. It is not a contract nor an agreement, but a sacred covenant where two individuals become one unit, or as the Bible says, one flesh. The true art of a married life is an inner spiritual journey. It's a mutual enrichment. Sorry, the water. It's a mutual enrichment, a give and take between two personalities, a mingling of two endowments which diminish neither, but enhances both. Jason and Riddell, marriage will allow you a new environment to share your lives together, standing together to face life and the world hand in hand. It will change you, define you, deepen your love for one another. To be successful, you will need God, love, strength, courage, patience, and at times, especially with Jason, a good sense of humor. So let your marriage be a time of waking each morning and falling in love with each other all over again. Jason, you are here today to become a husband to Riddell. Understand that the role of a husband is not something to be taken lightly. For God tells us that the husband is to be a true leader in the home, one who serves his wife sacrificially, putting her needs before yours, as Jesus puts our needs before his. Riddell, you are here today to become a wife to Jason. Understand that the role of wife is not something to be taken lightly. For God tells us that a wife is to be a helpmate, a cheerful companion, and one who submits to her husband's leadership just as the church is to submit to the leadership of Jesus. Let's pray. Dear God, thank you for this day. Thank you for this amazing couple who are here to enter a most special and sacred relationship, one that you have ordained. We invite your presence in the presence of your spirit. We pray that Jason and Riddell always remember that you are here, or you are to be at the center of their relationship and always the constant star that they can keep their eyes fixed on when times grow difficult. Please bless this marriage and this couple. Fill their home with your love, your strength, and your peace. In Jesus' name, amen. Now time to exchange the vows, and the bride and groom have prepared their own. Jason, how about you start us off here, sir?
Do we want them to be here?
Copy. You are the light of my world. Your smile always brightens my day. Your love is the song that my heart sings. Your kindness is a melody for my soul.
Look at me. I have no backup.
You're good.
Four lines.
You are an amazing person and my best friend. You compliment my strengths and lift me up in time of need. I am completely and utterly in love with you. As we stand here now before God and our dearest family and friends, I promise to always be loving, kind, and faithful. I will be the best husband I can be. My life is yours. I look forward to growing old with you, and if our relationship is a preview of our future, life will be filled with unending Netflix binges, spontaneous drives to nowhere, and of course, 4-hour shopping trips to the mall. Though life will have its road bumps, and the path may not always be clear, with you by my side, I'll always remember that life isn't about waiting for the storm to pass. It's about learning to dance in the rain. I promise. I promise that you'll never dance alone. I will love you with all of my heart for the rest of my days.
It's just rain, Jason.
Oh, it's rain.
I'm gonna try really hard. Jason, you've been my best friend for 8 years. You have been here with me through the good times and the bad times to encourage me, to comfort me, and to make me laugh. I fell in love with your heart, and I love you more today than I could ever imagine. I promise to love you unconditionally through the sunshine and the storm. I pray that I love you. I promise to be your partner in all things, along with Boo and Biz. I promise to never put avocado on your sandwich. I promise to give Star Wars a second chance. And I promise to help find the good in the darkest of times. I vow to love you.
I don't know if you're taking a breath, if you're crying, or that's great.
Throughout human tradition, when you make a pledge, it has been deemed good to have a token remind you of that pledge. For this purpose, you have chosen rings. The ring is an ancient symbol so perfect and simple, it has no beginning and it has no end. It is a circle, for love that is given comes back round again. Your rings are precious because you wear them with love. They symbolize your commitment in marriage. They remind you of who you are, where you've been, and where you're going. As you wear them through this time, they will reflect not only who you are as individuals, but also who you are as a couple. May we have the rings.
I love the rings.
Jason with them first. Jason, we'll start with you. Take her hand. Don't put the wrong one yet. Take her hand now. There we go. Jason, please repeat after me. I give you this ring as a symbol of my vow to love you above all others.
I give you this ring as a symbol and vow to love you above all others.
Close enough. To always put you first.
To always put you first.
And to lead you faithfully.
To lead you faithfully.
To honor and cherish you.
To honor and cherish you.
In all times, in all places.
In all times, in all places.
And in all ways, forever.
And in all ways, forever.
You can now place the ring on her finger. You want to take Jason's hand. Okay, please repeat after me. I'll make it a little shorter this time.
Please.
I give you this ring as a symbol of my vow.
I give you this ring as a symbol of my vow.
To love you above all others.
To love you above all others.
To always put you first.
To always put you first.
And to follow and support you faithfully.
And to follow and support you faithfully.
To honor and cherish you.
To honor and cherish you.
In all times.
In all times.
In all places. Always and forever.
Always.
Nina May now place the ring on his finger. Now that Jason and Riddell have given themselves to each other by a solemn vow, with the joining of hands and the giving and receiving of a ring, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Those whom God has joined together, let no one put asunder. Woo-hoo. You may kiss the bride.
Oh yeah!
Yeah.
Woohoo! Yeah!
Jason, I've known you since you've been in middle school, probably. stinking up our house playing video games till 3 in the morning. But you guys are, you know, you're an amazing couple.
Not much has changed.
You're an amazing couple and two people that I truly, my wife and I truly love and we really appreciate. And, you know, when you asked me to officiate your wedding, it was a tremendous honor. I'm really happy to be here because I believe in you guys. I see the way you have grown together as individuals. I see how you matured. And as a couple, you've always been amazing. Trust me, I've seen some couples where I don't know what the heck they're thinking, but you're not one of them. You guys have always just seemed to get each other's back. The vows that you spoke came alive. It was great. But all that being said, why I personally, and I'm sure everyone here enjoys being here for this start of a new life. The reality is, the start isn't really what I care about. I want you guys to finish well, right? Because that's what it's all about. Anybody can start anything. You can start a race and quit 5 feet in. I can start a trigonometry problem and in about a half a second realize I'm in over my head, right? You can start anything. It doesn't mean anything. It's exciting, but it really carries no merit or weight. What matters is how you finish. Paul talks about that in the Bible. He says, I've finished the race, I've run the course. I've kept the faith. And that's what I want to see you guys do. I want to see you finish well. But, so in light of that, I'm going to take the 2 hours you gave me, just kidding, to give you 4 pointers, tips, whatever you want to call it, to ensure that you finish well. And all 4 of these things are honestly just how you love each other. They all relate to love. Because, of course, in a marriage, if you need one thing, you need love. But in society, sadly, we've cheapened the word love. We really have. When you think about it, it's like, I love this car. I love these pants. I love this song. No, you don't, right? I mean, I think most of the men in this room can say that they've loved the car at some point in their life. And then after the first $1,000 garage bill, they hated it. And they couldn't wait for it to get towed away. I've been there, right? That's not love. But because we use it in such a peasantly way, love has become this cheap thing. And people say, oh, I love him and I love her and we're gonna get married. But they don't really know what true love is, because true love is special. It's not normal. It's supernatural, in fact. God is the author of love. He is love. True love is amazing. It's not something that you just say because you want it. Does that make sense? So with that being said, 4 ways that I would like to see you love. And these are all ways that, honestly, you just need to look to Jesus and you can see how it happens. And the first is you need to love each other continually and endlessly. There is no, I'll love you today, we'll see you about next year. Right? Unfortunately, a lot of relationships are like that though. Yeah, we'll see how it goes. But that's not the way it is. True love is, I'm going to love you now and forever, no matter what. There is no end. God says in the Bible, He loves us with a continual love, an everlasting love. There is no end to His love. He doesn't say, well, hey, it's 2030. I think I've loved them long enough. No, it just keeps going. And that's the way you need to love each other. You need to love each other continually, knowing that there is no end to your love. Second thing you need to do is you need to love each other intentionally. What I mean by that is this. In Hollywood, a lot of times, we make love this thing that happens, right? It's this secret sauce. It just kind of, oh, hey, look at that. What the heck? I'm in love. But that's not love, right? Affection can happen spontaneously. Infatuation. Attraction. But love is intentional. Make no mistake about it. You can choose to love someone, or you can choose not to love them. God doesn't love us because it just turned out that way. He chooses to love us. Despite our brokenness and our mess ups, He continues to love us. And that's how you guys need to be with each other. You need to choose to love each other. Because I assure you, there are going to be days where you're not really feeling like loving anybody. And I'm going to pick on you because I know you the longest. But when you come home and it's a bad day at work, and all you want to do is veg on the couch and play Xbox until your eyes bleed, right? I understand that. You want to decompress. It's what you need in that moment. But that's when you need to say, no, my wife might have had a bad day too, and I've been called to be her husband. I need to be intentional, and I need to make sure I love her tonight, even though I don't really feel like it. See, love's not about feelings. It's about a choice. I need to love you because I choose to love you. Does that make sense? Third, you gotta love each other sacrificially. And this one's hard for everybody, because let's be honest, sacrifice is, we like to say, oh, I'm sacrificial, but until it hurts, right? But you need to love each other sacrificially. Unfortunately, too many times you see people where the attitude is, hey, it's all about you until it stops being all about me. In other words, listen, life is great for me, so I can put all my attention on you. But the minute it goes a little awry, all the attention's back on me. That's not love, right? Love is sacrificial. It's always about each other. It's always about my needs under your needs for both of you. There's gonna be times where your wants are gonna have to come under the authority of her wants, and your needs are gonna have to come under the authority of his needs because you're sacrificing. And there is no better example of a sacrifice than, of course, Jesus, right? I mean, it says in the Gospels that he cried, he sweated blood in Gethsemane, asking God, is there another way? Because he didn't want to die, right? Like, no one wants to do that, especially the horrific way he did. And it's not just a saying. I mean, it's actually a medical fact that people can sweat blood if under enough duress. He really didn't want to do it. But he did it anyway because he knew there was no other way. He had to die so we could have life. And that is the type of sacrifice that you need to carry into a marriage. And the fourth thing is you need to love unconditionally. And that honestly is the hardest of the bunch. I know it doesn't sound like it, but it really is, because we put conditions on everything. None of us can truly love unconditionally. We like to think we can, but we can't. We can do the best we can. There's gonna be moments where you are gonna love unconditionally, and there's gonna be moments you put conditions on it. But you gotta try and you gotta strive to love each other unconditionally. Back in the 80s, when you guys were very young, and I was younger, Janet Jackson put out a song and said, "What have you done for me lately?" I'm not gonna break into dance, don't worry. But, you know, the reality is that's the way a lot of us think. It's like, hey, I love you, but what have you done for me lately? I don't know if I can keep loving you right now. There's not enough payback. But that's not what it's about, right? It's just unconditional. I love you because I love you. Doesn't matter what you do or what you don't do. Doesn't matter how messed up you are or how great you are. I'm gonna continue loving you. And that's the way God loves us. It's unconditional. Trust me, I don't know what he's thinking half the time, but he just continues to love us because it's an unconditional love. So, I'm very excited to be here, and I believe that if I've ever met a couple, that you guys haven't, right? I think you love each other those four ways, from what I've seen. And I have tremendous hope for you. Tremendous. But don't forget what you did here today. Don't forget what you brought here today, because there are going to be those moments where you're going to feel tempted to swerve and say, those four things are tough to do, maybe tomorrow. And I plead you, don't do that. Don't ever forget what you have here. You need to love endlessly. You need to love intentionally. You need to love sacrificially. And you need to love unconditionally. And if you do, what you start here today will end well. In fact, it'll end very well. It will be a love story that we all want to write. It'll be an example that you will be an example of the type of love Jesus has for us. And it'll be something that your kids can look at. And again, your love story won't just be a love story. It'll be actually your legacy. Do those four things and you'll end well. Let's pray. Dear God, thank you so much for this couple, for the love story they are about to write, for the legacy they will leave. We pray that every day Jason and Riddell keep you at the center of the relationship, so that when they draw close to you, they in turn also draw close to each other. May this couple and this marriage bring glory to you, as is a testament to your love for us. Let them not only start well, but finish well. We thank you and praise you for this day, this moment, and this new life story that is about to unfold. In Jesus' name, amen. Ladies and gentlemen, it's now my pleasure to present to you for the first time, Mr. and Mrs. Jason Walters. Woo!
going to get our bridal party in here, our parents, our grandparents are actually in here though. So at this time, we can have Bedella, Reed, Marie Jackson, Dominica Jackson, and Jean Walters. If you would please just give a little wave. Sign door there. Please welcome Joe and Paula Nessler and Helen Kessler. Also coming to this guys is our ringmaster and flower girl. Please welcome Krista and Nathaniel. All right, you guys are starting to let me down, but you guys got me some better grades than that. As we welcome our parents.
Colors and promises.
this time. If I could get all bride and groom to please make their way over to this beautiful wedding cake.
Oh, yep, yeah, that's a good cut.
This is supposed to be romantic. Okay, that's your huge piece.
Woo!
Is this how this works? Because my shirt
doesn't. Hold on, I'll come.
Hold on. We gotta give a kiss. Alright, now boots. Boots, real quick. Elle actually has a little surprise for Jason. Have a seat.
So, Jane Cookie's vows were fairly perfect because she's giving Star Wars a second chance, and I will include at least two Star Wars quotes in my speech. I have Star Wars socks on to celebrate the occasion and Star Wars cufflinks. So, many great speeches start with an inspiring quote. I don't want mine to be any different. I'd like to reference the great Admiral Ackbar with, "It's a trap." That's one of two. So be prepared. When Jay asked me to be his best man, I was honored. After about 30 seconds, he said, "I'm worried about what you might say." Having known Jay for a little short of 10 years, I could tell you hundreds of stories, but that's not why we're here today. We're here to celebrate the life of Jay and Cuppy and the life they'll spend together. I met Jay about a year or two before he and Cuppy started dating, and in that time, I had the opportunity to learn a lot about him. Jay was a caring, dedicated, and compassionate person with a huge heart for others. But something very unique to him was he never let go of the unique parts of childhood. Jay was fun to be around and brought excitement and energy to everything he did. We could have become partners in crime. When Jay and Cuppy started dating, it was a beautiful October day. But more importantly, none of those great qualities ever changed. Getting to know Cuppy over the years has been just as great a growing and learning experience. Cuppy loves to celebrate everything. Everything. Every single birthday. She loves time with friends and family. But something that surprised me when I got to know her was that she, like Jay, never lost the beautiful parts of childhood that so many of us have forfeited over the years. Cuppy embodies the quote, "Dance like no one's watching." Through her love of celebrating all parts of life and her love of life itself that shines through. Seeing the two of you grow together has been a testament to how true love and friendship create stronger and better people. Not losing parts of yourself, but instead enriching them. Before Cuppy, Jay was a great man. After Cuppy, Jay became an even better man, stronger, more amazing. She never subtracted, only multiplied. Here are just a few of the things I've learned from watching the two of you grow and build a life together. Celebrate everything. Life and love are beautiful gifts shared in celebration with the ones you love. There's too many road bumps along the way to cherish every smile and moment fully. No matter where you are or what you're doing, there's always time for a good night call. Always. Jay has made many good night calls, regardless of what we were doing, every night. I'll admit that took me longer to learn. Finding someone truly to love and share your life with doesn't mean growing, giving up parts of yourself, but instead letting someone into your life and heart who supports who you are and amplifies and encourages the beautiful part of your personality. In closing, I ask that the two of you never let go of your fun and exuberant qualities. Stay young at heart and keep buying Nerf guns. Continue celebrating everything in life. It will brighten the beautiful moments and help light the path during those darker times. Stay best friends. Your relationship and love is a testament to the beauty that exists in life. Keep letting those around you see all the power and energy that true love can breathe into life. Most importantly, remember, the force will always be with you. I ask that everyone raise their glasses now in a toast to Jay and Poppy.
Do you want your glass?
No, I'm just going to raise my cup. My favorite. Yeah, no, it's fine. Enjoy it. I'll save my drink.
You sure?
To Jay and Poppy.
Hi, everyone.
Yeah.
Just bear with me because I've never given this speech before, but that's how much Puppy means to me that I'm standing up here giving this speech.
So we all grew up together. I first met Cuppy when I was 11 years old. I was supposed to take her over to Sunday school class, and I completely forgot. I'm sitting in class thinking to myself, I feel like I'm going to forget something, or that I'm forgetting something. Afterwards, I saw her and her family talking to my grandma, and I instantly remembered, of course. Me forgetting about her would be the start of a beautiful, lifelong friendship. Of course, we had our ups and downs, like most friendships do, but we always got through it. We started so many fun memories together. Like the time I locked us out of my house after a midnight beach excursion with Jason, and we had to sleep in the back seat of her car. I remember that as Jason and Jackie. I also remember the time I got dressed up and waited in line to sit with the Easter Bunny. Remember all the strange looks we got that day? I remember seeing that picture, and it was very strange. Two grown women at the Deptford Mall, waiting in line in full sundresses to take a Easter Bunny picture.
They were
prom dresses. You're the only person in the world that could bring me out of my comfort zone. This is a perfect example of that. You brought out the side of me that I never knew existed. There is no greater gift in life than having you as my best friend. And not only did I have the privilege of growing up with both of you, but I also got to witness your love grow stronger as time went by. I want to thank you for allowing me to stand by your side on your special day, and there is no one else I know that deserves happiness more than the two of you do. So here's to Cuppy and Jason for starting a new chapter in your lives. I wish you nothing but the best of luck, and congratulations to getting married.
Here.
So everyone raise your glass.
Say ignore them till they fade away. Amazing they are great, but after all the game I gave away, safe to say I paved the way for you cats to get paid today. You'd still be wasting days away now had I never saved the day. Consider them my protege, homage I think they should pay. Instead of being gracious, they violate in a major way. I never been a hater, still I love them in a crazy way. Some say they sold the yay, and know they couldn't get work on Labor Day. It ain't that black and white, it has an area that's shaded gray. I'm west side anyway, even if I left today and stayed away. Some move away to make away. Not move away, cause they afraid. I brought back to the hood, and all you ever did was take away. I pray for patience, but they make me wanna melt their face away. Like I once made them spray, now I can make them put the K's away. Been thugging all my life, can't say I don't deserve to take a break. You'd rather see me catch a case and watch my future fade away. Of a hustler and the swagger of a college kid. Allergic to the counterfeit, impartial to the politics, articulate, but still a grabber by the collar quick. Whoever having problems with their record sales, just holler till. If that don't work and all us fails, then turn around and follow till. I got love for the game, but hey, I'm not in love with all of it. Could do without the fame, and rappers nowadays are comedy. The hooting and the hollering back and
forth. On three, here we go. One, two, and three. Ha ha ha!